Good morning, friends. I'm Navin Reddy. So today we'll talk about one of the amazing concepts of Java, or you can say object-oriented concepts. It's something called as constructors. Now, if you talk about constructor, it is very essential when you talk about objects. Because think in this way now. If you work with any object-oriented programming system, you have to work with object. And when you talk about object, it will take some memory of your RAM or of your hard drive. So if you talk about objects, they require memory. And the basic thing about providing a memory is given by constructors. Now, to deal with constructors is not that difficult, but I don't know why people tend to make it difficult. Think about this now. Let's suppose you have a class. So let's define a class here. We have a simple class A. So if you talk about this class A, obviously, we'll be having some variables, we'll be having some methods, because if we talk about object, objects are created by class, and object has two things. Object knows something, object does something. So object knows something with the help of variables or constants. Object does something with the help of methods. Now, if we talk about a class, so let's suppose we have one variable here, which is int I. Okay, and I need a method. Like if we talk about a variable will have some data, and if we want to get that data, let's suppose I'm using a method called as public void show. Now this show method will print something. I want to print the value of I, so I can say it's system.out.println, and in this I will print value of I. Now this is very simple class. As you know, you might be familiar with Java. This is very simple class with one variable and one method. We should print the value of I. Now if you want to work with this class, you have to create objects, right? Obviously, without creating object, you cannot do anything. You require objects, right? Because both these members, variable and this method, both are non-static. And if you want to work with any non-static method, you require object. Now to call this function, we require one more class, or you can say in this class only we'll be having a method. Okay, because obviously your Java application will be working with JVM, and if we talk about JVM requires main method. Okay, so we require a main method here. So let's start with main method. Now imagine everything I'm writing on this board will be between this class, in this class. So imagine we have class open here and class close here with those variable and method also. It's there. We want some additional methods here. Now if we talk about main method, think about this. Now you have a main method. You have to define main method in this way. So it's main. Now when you talk about a method will do something for you. So if you want to make your method work, you have to provide it something. Not always, but method expect, you will give something, and if you give something, it has to be used as parameters. So it's, or you can say arguments, the string args, it will take a string array. Now methods return something, so we have void. And now most of the people ask me why main function is static. Now think about this. To work with methods, we require object, because methods are of two types. One is static method, second is non-static method. So if we talk about a main method, it's a, or you can say function, so it will be very simple for you. If we talk about a main function, it can be two types, static or non-static. If you have a function which is non-static, obviously you require object, because non-static methods belongs to object. So to call main function, if it is non-static, if you to call main function, you require object. And the starting point of your Java code is main function. That means without calling main, you cannot create object. Without creating object, you cannot call main. It's something like a deadlock situation you have. So to clear this concept, we have this main function which should be static, so that you don't require an object to call it. Right? You can use a class name. So static methods uses class name. So we have main function which is static. That means it don't require a object. Then obviously we want a public method because we want to access this main method from anywhere. So we have public static void main. Now if I open this, I have to create object of A. So to create object of A, it will be created in two steps. First, we have to create reference. So A, OBJ. Now this is called as reference. You can use it, but you cannot call any members because if you talk about reference, it will not consume any memory. And to work with any task, or if you want to work with objects, you require memory. So to provide memory, we have this amazing keyword called as new. So new means it will provide you some new memory. Now question arises, if you have any time bought that air pillow, like this, we have this air pillow. So if you talk about that air pillow, so air pillow, if you buy it, you will not having any air, right? You will be getting a plain pillow. If you want to use it, you have to blow some air. So if you blow some air, it will, you know, it will get into that working position and you can then use it. Or you can use a balloon, right? When you buy a balloon, it's like a plain balloon. If you want to use it, if you want to enjoy with your balloon, big balloon, you have to blow some air. Blowing some air is like a new keyword. So we will blow some air. Question is how much, right? So if you blow more than the required air, it will blast. If you blow less than the required thing, it will not work. So if you want to work with object, you have to provide some memory. Question arises, how much? And then that how much is provided by constructor. So constructor provides or allocates memory to your object. It provides the size of your object. Because see, if you talk about int variable, int I, you know the size of I. So I is 4 bytes. If you say float, we know the size. If you talk, say double, we know the size. But if you talk about object of A, we don't know the size, right? We cannot say size is 8 bytes or 16 bytes. It all depends upon number of variables, right? So we cannot count all this. So our work is done by constructors. Now constructor is defined, or it can be used with, it's same as a class name. So your class name is A. So constructor name should be A. Because it's a member function, you have to provide a packets. So you can say constructor is a member function with the same name as class name, right? So now with this constructor, with this object, now you can call those methods. So we can say obj I equal to 5, and then finally you can say obj dot show. This is possible because we are working with constructors. Now till now, if you have done any Java code, maybe you have not used constructors. But system in build have a feature of constructors, right? So if you're not defining it, it's okay. System will define it for you. But if you want to define by yourself, you can do it. It's not that difficult. Let's define a constructor. So to define a constructor, we have to provide constructor name, which is A, with brackets, right? Then we have to provide, now see, if you talk about functions, they will return something. Constructor returns memory. It will not return any value, right? So we don't have to provide that return type. So directly we can say it's public. So you can say public A, right? Now you can do any initialization task here. So if you want to provide I value by directly without object, if you want to provide I value, you can say I value directly is 0. It's an initial value for I. So you can use constructor to initialize items also. So if you want to initialize variables, you can do it. If you want to open a file, you can do it. If you want to go for networking, like if you want to create sockets, if you want to create database connections, you can do all those things in constructor, right? So initialization part comes in constructors. Okay. Now you might be knowing a concept of method overloading, right? So if you have two methods with the same name but different parameters, it is called as method overloading. What if I have two constructors? Let's suppose I have constructor with zero parameters and I have one more constructor with a parameter j. It means we have public A with int j, and here I say I equal to j. You might be knowing in this class I have declared a variable called as I. So it's I equal to j. It means we have two constructors with the same name, obviously constructor will have the same name because they belong to the same class, same name, different parameters. This concept is called as constructor overloading. So you can have multiple constructors in the same class provided they have different signatures. Signatures means they have different parameters. Okay. Then question arises, how to call this constructor? If you want to call this constructor, it's very simple. See, constructors, you cannot call constructor yourself, right? You cannot say it's obj.constructor. If you want to call a constructor, you have to create object. So whenever you create any object, constructor get automatically called. So it means if you want to call a constructor, you have to create objects. That means to call this constructor, we have to say it's a obj equal to new a. Now if you say default, it will call this constructor. To call this constructor, you have to provide some value. So if you say a phi, it will call this constructor and your I will be phi. This is how you have to work with constructor. You can have multiple parameters. You can have default parameter, which is this one, with zero, we also call it zero parameters. This is one parameter. You can have multiple parameters, right? This is what we're going to talk about, constructor overloading. Now, see, it's not that difficult, but sometimes you have private constructors, you have this copy constructors. They are not that difficult, but people tend to make it difficult. So my suggestion is, start with small constructors, then expand yourself to go with private constructor. The only thing in private constructor is, if you have a private constructor, you cannot create an object. Okay, so I hope it helps you. So if you have any doubts, please comment in and please subscribe for further videos. Thank you so much.